Welcome to Grayon Math. We are asked to solve for this problem. In the figure below, BC is the diameter of a circle centered at O, which intersects AB and AC at D and E, respectively. Suppose that AD is equal to 9 and DB is equal to 4. And ACD is congruent to angle DOB. Find the length of AE. Okay, but before we go to the solution, may I request you to please like the video. Okay, so first thing that we need to consider is that the diameter of the semicircle is CB. The center is at O, and the length from C to O is actually the radius of the circle, and same with the distance OB, it is the radius of the circle, and also same with the length OD. And we can say that this triangle COD is actually an isosceles triangle, and in an isosceles triangle, the two angles opposite the two sides are congruent. If this is theta, then this is theta also. Okay. So, and from that, we can say that by exterior angle theorem, that the exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of two opposite interior angles. So, since the two opposite interior angles here are theta and theta, and the exterior angle is angle DOB, then angle DOB is actually 2 times theta. And it is also given that angle DOB is equal to angle ACD. So angle ACD is actually equal to 2 theta. Okay, so next thing that we have to notice is that angle CDB is actually a right angle because of Thales theorem. Thales theorem states that if AC is a diameter and B is a point on the diameter circle, the angle ABC is a right triangle. But in our case, on the problem, CB is the diameter and D is the point on the diameter circle, and the angle CDB is a right angle. And also, since ADB is a straight line, and this angle also is a right angle, so we have two right triangles for this figure. Notice that earlier we said that there are two right triangles, and that is triangle CAD and triangle CDB. And their common side is CD. If we focus on triangle ACD, then we can say that tangent of 2 theta is actually equal to 9 over DC. And tangent theta from the other right triangle, which is triangle CDB, we can say that theta is equal to 4 over DC. Okay, so next step is we use the double angle identity for tangent, since we got a value for tangent to theta, which is equal to 9 over DC, and tangent theta equal to 4 over DC. Then if we use double angle identity for tangent, then we have tangent 2 theta equal to 2 times tangent theta all over 1 minus tangent square theta. But tangent 2 theta is actually equal to 9 over DC equal to 2 times tangent theta is now equal to 4 over dc all over 1 minus 4 over dc square. So you can actually say that 9 over dc equal to 8 over dc all over, if we simplify this on the denominator, we have actually this becomes 16 over dc square. Then if that is 16 over dc square, then we have this common denominator will be dc square. So dc square divided by 1 is equal to dc square minus dc square divided by dc square equal to 1 times 16. Then this is 16. Then if we invert this on the right hand side, we have 8 over dc times dc square all over dc square minus 16. Then this is the same thing, 9 over dc. Then we can simply cancel this dc. Then this becomes 9 times dc square minus 16 equal to 8 times dc square. If you cross multiply, then 9 dc square minus 9 times 16 is equal to 144, is equal to 8 dc square. But 9 dc, if we put this 8 here and we have 9 dc square minus 8 dc square is equal to 144, then we have dc square is equal to 144. Then if we take the square root of both sides, then we have dc is equal to 12 units. Okay, so next thing is we need to focus on triangle ADC. And triangle ADC is actually a right triangle. And since we know that the length of DC is equal to 12 and the length of AD is 9, which is given, we can find the length of AC. So AC is simply equal to the square root of AD square plus CD square. So AC is actually equal to AD, which is equal to 9. So that would give us 9 squared plus CD, which is actually equal to 12 units squared. So AC equal to the square root of 81 plus 144. So this gives us AC is equal to the square root of 225, or AC is equal to square root of 15 squared. So AC is equal to 15 units. Okay, so for the final step is we need to use the Secant theorem. And in this case, if we use the Secant theorem, then we have AD times AB equal to AE times AC. Okay, so AD is actually equal to 9, but AB is equal to 9 plus 4, that is AB. And AE is the unknown. This is what we are looking for, and AC is actually equal to 15. as we got earlier. So AE is equal to 9 times 13 over 15. So we divide the numerator and the denominator by 3, we have 3 over 5. So 3 times 13 is 39, which gives us 39 all over 5 units. And that is our final answer. So thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.